Good morning. This is All India Radio, Kohima. The morning news read by Jonas Yantan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said he will highlight the need to comprehensively address climate change issues, including equitable distribution of carbon space and importance of sustainable lifestyles for green and inclusive growth at a World Leaders Summit during COP26. In his departure statement ahead of his visit to Rome and Glasgow, Modi said COP26 summit will also provide an opportunity to meet with all the stakeholders, including leaders of partner countries, innovators, and intergovernmental organizations, and explore the possibilities for further accelerating clean growth. Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance launched a Pan-India Credit Outreach Camp with a view to boost credit for all-round economic growth post-COVID-19 pandemic. Accordingly, Lead Bank Office, Kohima, organised a credit outreach initiative programme yesterday at LCS Building, Kohima, for handing over of sanctioned letters to the beneficiaries. Additional Deputy Commissioner Kohima and Bhavani Sri, addressing the gathering, lauded the bankers for the impressive credit growth in Kohima in spite of the COVID-19 pandemic, and also encouraged the member banks to help grow agricultural economy. During the campaign, the banks operating in Kohima were able to disperse more than 31 crore rupees to 460 beneficiaries. Supreme Court cleared the way for the National Testing Agency to declare the results of NEET-UG 2021 examination by staying Bombay High Court decision to conduct fresh exams for two aspirants. The aspirants had complained in the court that they were handed question papers and answer sheets with different serial numbers. A bench led by Justice L. Nageshwara Rao froze the High Court order, allowing the NEET results to be declared. The bench said it would consider the case of the two students, including what could be done for them in detail later. The court reiterated that there was no reason to withhold the results because of a complaint made by two students. The future of lakhs of students was at stake. There are 16 lakh students who are eagerly waiting for the results. To commemorate the celebration of 75 years of India's independence, Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, we present India at 75 quiz with AIR News Kohima, a special quiz on India's freedom movement and its glorious history. The quiz is being conducted every Thursday in the evening news at 7:10 and 7:20 p.m. and continues till 15th August 2022. Recalling our yesterday's question, who was the chairman of the drafting committee of Indian Constitution? The correct answer is Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. And the winner of the quiz is Vinitoli from Dimapur. Congratulations, Vinitoli from Team AIR News Kohima. Joint inspection of Kohima Jessami two-lane project was carried out by Chakhasang Youth Front, Chakhasang Students Union and CPO. The inspection, interacting with the implementing agencies, stressed upon quality of work, timely completion of the project and other relevant issues. The joint inspection team also reiterated its earlier stand not to entertain any illegal taxation by an individual or groups which will hamper the progress and development of the project in particular and public in general. In addition, the inspection team appealed the landowners not to obstruct the work or lodge complaints when they are duly compensated, and also demolish the structures for smooth sailing of the project. Union Minister for Science and Technology Dr. Jitendra Singh said telemedicine technology could save India around $5 billion annually. Singh said telemedicine is no longer an option but a necessity. He said digital health is the next frontier to ensure healthcare delivery is accessible, available and affordable. Singh further called for innovative healthcare solutions in a country like India, where there is shortage of medical professionals and millions live in rural areas. As India achieved the milestone of vaccinating 100 crore people against COVID-19, All India Radio salutes all the people, doctors, nurses and others who made this possible. Even though the country has achieved this feat, we caution our listeners that the battle against COVID is not yet over. We appeal to our listeners who are yet to get fully vaccinated to get vaccinated at the earliest, and also help others to get vaccinated. During the festival season, please follow these three simple steps. Wear a face mask, maintain 6 feet for social distancing, focus on hand and face hygiene. For any COVID-related information and guidance, contact National Helpline numbers 011-2397-8046 and 1075 and State Helpline number 1800-345-0019. With that, we come to the end of the morning news. Have a nice day.